So we have various tourism destinations which we really pushed to our Department of Tourism and to DPWH. The key thing there is when a certain regional office is requiring you to submit something, you need to submit ASAP and comply the requirements, because opportunity knocks only once. That's why this is we are doing our part also for the tourism investors to come in, because as local government, we are encouraged to develop our roads, our facilities, and do our local investment code for them to have some benefits from us, and to put in place the things that is needed to be served with the government, so that investors will just come in and see. Right? Our next accomplishment is our BUB. Many of you knew about bottom-up budgeting, right? That's the time of income. And some of the LGUs, it depends on their priority areas, which they are going to fund. And for tourism, we are really fortunate that we were considered to be one of the priority areas of the LGU. So we submitted for skills training of our mountain guides, because Talisay City is known as ecotourism destinations, and we have our Sulcatara and Tinawagdaga for trekking. So we need to capacitate and train our guides, our mountain partner guides, to be skilled. So it is funded under our BUB program. We also have our housekeeping, because tourism, it needs to provide trainings for our housekeepers, because most of our hotels and resorts needs housekeepers. Based on our survey, housekeeping is their number one requirement. So we did a training for them to provide our manpower skills, so that they won't find it hard to hire a housekeeper anymore. So what we do is we identify housekeepers in the 27 barangays of Talisay. We provide for their transportation, we provide for their training fees, and they are being trained by TESDA accredited schools. And their OJT is being done in our DOT accredited hotels. So we make a partnership with Nature's Village, with Compass Island Resort, with other resorts in the city of Talisay. And also we ask participants from them to be trained, para it won't be hard for them anymore to look for people who will do their housekeeping. Okay? We also did our souvenir programs, our souvenir projects, and that is pottery. We did it with our BJMP inmates, because here there are trainings that we conducted, but we realized that some of the trainees just do enroll and there's no sustainability anymore. So just like in some other project that goes white elephants. So we discovered that BJMP or the inmates are people that they have a lot of idle times. So it's we converted their idle times into a productive one. And we've seen them doing already some local products, but we realize that they're the most effective and efficient trainees na itap namin. So fortunately, they have wonderful skills in pottery, in carvings, because we also did wood carvings with them. And now, nung pumasok sila sa jail, it's their family who's giving them money to buy something. Ngayon, sila na nagbibigay ng money becomes an income generating thing at BJ. So I don't know if you will have time, if you will drop by our visitors information center, you will see a lot of their products there. We also did our tour guiding day trainee, or Miss Betsy, one of your tour guides, were one of our speakers there. Because in tourism, we really need to train people in order to supply the needs of the manpower of tourism industry. So just a while ago, you've seen our two beautiful tour guides come on. Please stand up. Sheena and Karen. Yeah, they just graduated from our tour guiding training done by DOT and the province of Negros Occidental and Dream Philippines. And Karen was the top notcher of their batch.
Wow.
And Sheena was one of the top five. Okay. And they were the scholars of our LGU because we really see the need that in every LGU, we need to have a tour guide that's DOT trained for the standard instrument system, right? So, kanina, it seems that you really enjoy the half shepherd and half German. Okay, so we trained, let's go back to our tour guides. So we trained from the grassroots. Every fiesta, we have our tour guiding competition here. So we have our elementary, our secondary level. And then the winner will be sent to the provincial level. Because during our tourism month, we have our tour guiding competition province-wide. So our elimination process is through our fiesta activity. So all the winners from elementary and secondary, we call them and we did the DOT tour guiding training. And it was funded by our bottoms-up budgeting. Kaya naka-uniform sila. So there you are. Meron kaming mga nag-mock tour din sila. So it's just developing the skill from the grassroots, and then they will realize their potentials, and then, well, they will just learn along the way. Okay. So we realize that tour guiding is really an industry right now, right, Miss Maricar and Miss Betsy? Okay. So there's really a shortage of tour guide in Negros Occidental, and there are about six of them that's DOT accredited. Seven of them are DOT accredited. So we were really inspired by the tourism industry needs in the province when we had our local government support program. So we were funded by the national government to really study on the support program needs of the tourism industry. So. This is an advantage if you really grab the opportunity. Okay, so we have candle making training, considering that the city government of Talisay is a pilgrimage site of San Vicente Ferrer. I don't know later if you're going to pass by there if you have time. So we did a candle that has a sticker of San Vicente Ferrer because we have a lot of pilgrimage visitors here visiting San Vicente Ferrer every Friday because they have this belief of healing to the saint and performing miracles and their petitions. Okay, next. We have our t-shirt printing for our t-shirt souvenirs. And this BUB project, all in all, we got from BUB national is 1.2 million worth of training. So imagine kung kukunin niyo yan sa internal revenue allocation niyo. So, pag national grant, talagang it's an edge. Right? So, next is jewelry making. Yeah. So, we identify the souvenirs. Now, it's product development for tourism. Na mabibili ninyo ng mga turista namin. We also have our bamboo craft. So, why the OT is going to have this kind of thing? First is we grab the opportunity. Second is we submit our tourist because number one deliverables of the DOT office or the tourism office is submitting our tourist arrivals every month. Right? So, kaya naman ang tourism officer dito. So, the city of Talisay has a tourist arrivals of, in 2018, we have 466,664 day tourists. Meaning to say, like you, you visit Talisay, you visit ruins, you visit Kampasan Highland Resort, but you don't sleep here, so we count you as our excursionist or day tourist. So we count you in. And we were top one in a day tourist destination all over Negros Oxford. That's, well, maybe because of the ruins, because a lot of people really go to the ruins, but it's a must-see attraction. And our Compuesto One Highland. So, dalawa silang nag-deliver talaga ng day tourists sa amin. For accommodations or guest nights, these are data that being reported by hotels. Now, natutulog kayo dito sa amin, so we will come to you again. So, our guest nights for 2018 is 49,975. So, if DOT see that we are submitting regularly these things, and we are supporting this to our tourism roads, to their other programs, parang you are already 80% room to your proposal. You are always their priority. So, that's the increasing tourist arrivals that we have. Yeah, and we are really encouraging right now. There is a memorandum from Secretary Anyo that all major DOT establishment such as resorts, hotels, tour operators, tour guides, restaurants are mandated to apply for DOT. I don't know kung anong gagawin nila sa mga LGUs na hindi ini-encourage or hindi pinadala yung mga DOT establishment na magpa-accredit this year. Because as we know, diba si DNR nag-require na ng environmental clearance for all DOT-related establishment ng Yankees. So this time, mandatory yung environmental permit and DOT accreditations. Alright? So, that ends my presentation. Is there any question? Or later na, after Spike? Alright. So, thank you so much. I hope you can share this with your tourism officer.
Sige, don't worry, Ms. Renea. You'll get to share it again in person with probably in the next batch. But salamat gid. Can we give Ms. Renea and Sampere another round of applause? Tourism management is an overwhelming task. But if I were to highlight some of the lessons learned from her presentation, it will include the following. Number one, that as tourism managers and tourism officers, it's very important for us to focus on the 5 A's of tourism. That's attractions, accessibility, accommodation, amenities, and activities. I think the first that we did was to ensure that we've mapped out all of our tourism destinations. And secondly, through an infrastructure project, we've guaranteed that these are accessible via road networks. Thirdly, accommodations have to be equipped properly, and that's the reason why we had side-by-side with that a skills training to ensure the needs of the industry by way of house cleaning. We've even had some who had trainings on food and beverage because that's also a growing need of the industry. I think equally important is that we're able to ensure activities that will sustain and nurture your influence and probably prolong your stay in the city. So moving forward, we are looking at maybe the next phase to our tourism experience is to make it an experiential tourism. So baka next time, you'll find yourself crafting your own jewelries. Kasi part na siya ng tourism package. I think secondly, it's also equally important that tourism development and management can only be successful if we have an integrated and comprehensive approach. So there's strong partnership from private and public entities, ensuring infrastructure development and complementing it with manpower and skills training. So I hope that's a story that will inspire you to also emulate some of our practices. At this point, we are also ready to listen now to some of our best practices in the area of disaster risk reduction and management. It's a relatively young office, probably 2 or 3 years in the making, and it is currently headed by our executive assistant and concurrently officer in charge of the city DRMO office, Mr. Joferi Spines Gutierrez. Maraming pa lang para mag-iis ko na.
Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. In Ilonggo, Maayong Hapon. Welcome no, sa city of Talisay. So, my task today is to ipakita po sa inyo yung best practices namin sa disaster. Actually, yung disaster office namin po ay nag-assume na kami ng office. Ikat third year namin ngayon. So, bali infancy stage pa po kami. So, ito na po yung mga ano, mga na-accomplish namin sa DRR. By the way po sir, sa Iraq, at sa inyo po ba, Batac po ba, ano po yung number one hazard na araw-araw na ano yun po? Flooding. Okay. Dito po sa amin, sa Talisay, maswerte po kami, siguro sa, dahil na po sa ano, geographical position ng Talisay City, minimal lang po yung flooding namin. Wala po kami masyadong dito po kami masyadong niyadaan ng typhoon. Wala po ng natural hazard na dumadaan sa amin. Pero yung araw-araw na hinaharap namin is yung human induced or yung human hazard po, which is the vehicular accident po. So araw-araw po, mayroon kaming average ng 5 to 8 vehicular accident. Siguro nasa 30 or 40% mga major accident po yan. Okay? Okay. So, pag-upugot sa aming mayor na si Mayor Neil Lizares, yung number one na sa platform niya po, yung number one niya is yung disaster preparedness po. So, nung nag-upo siya, bumili po kami ng mga equipments like yung rescue truck namin. Okay. By the way po pala, yung office namin is currently, meron na po kaming 35 na personnel. So yun po ba sir, marami po kayo. So we have 35 personnel kasi po meron kaming services na in-offer. Yung fire and rescue po. Meron po kami mga fire trucks, rescue capabilities, like mountain rescue, water rescue, at saka yung extrication po. At saka yung pinaka-last po namin, yung daily na routine po namin is yung EMS or which is the emergency medical services po namin. So, yun yung pong isang i-share namin dito. Okay? Pero punta po muna tayo sa aming ano, mga equipment. Kayo po ba sir? Marami na yun kayo mga equipment doon. Kailangan kasi natin bumili kasi under the law, kailangan natin mag-purchase ng mga ganyan. So, this is po yung ano namin, rescue truck. Itong truck na po ito, in whole Negros, kami po yung first na naka-acquire na dito. So, ano po siya? Yung capabilities niya, meron po siyang boom sa likuran, which is 3 times yung capacity. So, during vehicular accident, kaya po bumili kami ito dahil sa vehicular accident na na-encounter namin. So, during vehicular accident po, siya po yung nagtutuo o nag-lift ng mga sasakyan na natutumba. So, inside niya po, sa loob niya, meron po siyang mga, lahat ng gamit namin ando dun sa loob. Hindi na po kami, pag may tawag, hindi na po kami kukuha sa stock room namin. Pag may tawag, diretso na kami. Kasi ando dun na po lahat, lahat yung mga extrication tools, water rescue, yung water rescue na equipment namin, ando doon na po lahat. Ito po yung boom niya sa likuran. Yan po isang example ng mga accident na nakikita nyo dito. Kasi po sa yung Talisay City, sa buong province po, kami lang po yung may dalawang highway. Yung National Road at saka yung sa likuran yung bagong highway na gawa. Yung access road. So ngayon po mayroon pa nga plano, nadagdagan pa po yung highway namin, yung coastal road. So magiging tatlo na. So magiging tatlo na rin po yung babantayan namin. Eh ito po, meron siya pong mga abilities na yung may meron siyang pang queens na pang pool. Okay. At saka meron siyang lightings. Yung ilaw na yung ilaw niyan po, yung pinakamalayo niyang maabot is 2 kilometers. So, makikita po talaga kayo, si malayo yung ito po, yung ano namin, simulation namin sa Iloilo. Kasi po, in-invite kami ng OCD to join the simulation nung last time nung mag-NSID sa Iloilo City. So, dinala namin yung truck, yung personnel namin, saka nag-join kami ng simulation. Ito po yung mga sasakyan. Ito yung parating makikita namin. Usual to na makikita namin sa accident. Yan. Ganyan. Everyday po yan. Pero before kami mas marami po yan, mas marami pong aksidente. Yung ginawa kasi namin ngayon, meron kaming road safety program. So, nag-iipot yung isang sasakyan namin. Pag may merong nakikitang abriya na sasakyan, binalagyan po ng mga warning devices at saka yung tulungan ng abriya. Yung minsan na nagplaplatan, nawagsiraan. Yan. Ito po yung mga major accidents na namin. Nakikita nyo yung multi-cap. Parang hindi na siya multi-cap. Yan. Yun pong mga niya. Okay. Na-picture na rin po kami sa Cebu City na mga magazines. At saka sa Office of the Civil Defense po, na-picture na rin po yung office namin. Dahil sa mga ganitong practices namin. So ito po yung namin. Mga goals namin po. Yan. Pero hindi na natin i-discuss yan kasi magkaiba naman po yung goals ninyo. Dahil naman, iba naman po yung amin. Okay. Ito po siya. Okay. At saka ito yung po yung sa namin. Day-to-day na ginagawa namin. Meron po kasi kami sa Talisay mga pasyente na nagda-dialysis. So, yung isang ginagawa namin, binibigyan po sila namin ng transportation. Free po yan. Sunduin sa bahay. Yan din sa facilities like ito. At saka pagkatapos, susunduin na naman sila namin at saka ibabalik sa kanilang bahay. So, on a daily basis po, meron po kaming 15 to 20 dialysis na pasyente na hatid, sundo, hatid. 24 hours po yan, minsan madaling araw. At saka hindi po ito saan lang ha, sa urban area. Minsan sa ano. Oo. So, sa amin po kasi dito sa Talisay, yung pinaka number one ng mayor namin is to give yung pinaka basic services lang. Yun lang yun po yung ambulance services, tsaka yung sa rescue po kasi meron po kaming mga trained personnel. We have 5 EMT, emergency medical technician. We have 10 responder personnel. We have 10 also na firefighter or fireman na on standby po yan. 24/7 po. So, yun po yung sa amin sa disaster. So, pupuli na sa inyo po maging makabisita din po kami doon sa inyo.
Salamat, Sir Spikes. Okay. Si Sir Spike kasi medyo shy siya. Kanina may excuse pa siya not to give a presentation. Buti na lang natapos kaagad ang CDP. Kaya he has to do it on his own. But I think it speaks highly of the importance of leadership and support given to an initiative. I think I've noticed three important things from this presentation. Iba-iba kasi ang hazards of the different cities and municipalities. So perhaps the best way to move forward is number one, to customize shared projects, programs, and activities according to the nature of the hazards in your respective cities and municipalities. I think second, and he mentioned this, it's very important to develop around the strength of the team. I think one of our advantages, kaya lumaki ng 35 plus, because prior to CDRMO, may existing na po kaming volunteer rescue teams. This is Regent Incorporated. And when we institutionalize CDRMO, many of them have opted to join CDRMO either as personnel, official personnel sila, or as volunteer teams pa rin. And the third is that it's also very important to make sure that we will not have problems with audit, with liquidation and all these things. I think it's also very important to ensure that all of our PPAs are anchored on relevant legal frameworks and documents. That way, we are guaranteed that all of our initiatives and projects are assured of being implemented. So it's been an opportunity to share with you these two areas, tourism management and disaster risk reduction management, as what we would consider to be our in-house best practices. We'd now like to give a few minutes for any questions, clarifications that you'd like to ask in so far as tourism and DRM management is concerned. So the floor is now open for any thoughts that you'd like to share, response, clarification. I think there's another microphone earlier. Sige. Machine, kasi may gusto mag-ask question. Please don't be shy. The afternoon is young. We have a few more minutes to be able to share with you some thoughts, or maybe you have some reflections in so far as you have listened to our presentation. Baka excited na sila. I think you are all very excited to probably get the chance to see. Will you be visiting Campus Tuhan? Not anymore. Okay, so I hope that next time you will no longer be doing a benchmarking but enjoying the sights and attractions of the city. I think we'd like to leave you with this final word. A person feels appreciated. I'm sorry. We always do so much more than what is expected. So once again, warmest welcome to the city of Talisay, the home of the Minuluan Festival, and Guapo Nga Servicio. And kabay pa, I'm now speaking in Ilonga. And kabay pa, next time you will visit us to enjoy our tourism destinations and heritage homes. Madamog nga salamat, and once again, I am your host. I am May Liamas, the executive assistant to the mayor, and concurrently the local economic and investment promotion officer. Madamog nga salamat and may happy salamat. Yes, this afternoon we will break you up into two groups. No, we'd like to ask our officers to join you for a photo shoot in front of the Sandunian Panglungsod, and the other group.